oh boy, oh boy. We got a lot of news and a little bit of time to get to it. Now, check this out. I have read through this article extensively, so you don't have to. All you have to do is check the link in the description if you want to go over it very extensively. But other than that, hey, listen, man, it seems to me that the name of the game this year for 2K is symmetry. They want there to be, as I've always said, counterplay. There must be counterplay in every video game. Now, in real life, it's not fair. Basketball isn't fair. It wasn't fair that I can play above the rim and some people can't. It's not fair that I'm much faster than the next person is. It's not fair that I can dribble the ball and shoot from deep and get to the rim at will and still dunk on somebody every now and then and the next person can't. It's not fair. Basketball has never been a sport that's fair. And it's not fair that I can also turn around and block most shots on the other end. And it definitely isn't fair that I'm getting older and older, so I can't do a whole lot of that anymore. But the whole thing is, and so there's a new generation of kids that are coming up that I have to play 99% just to keep up with them. Whereas 10 years ago, they wouldn't have been able to, 10, 20 years ago when I was 19, couldn't even stood on the same court with me. So with all that being said, this is a video game. So there must be balance. There must be counterplay. Because anytime you have something in a video game that is overpowered and abusable, the community will inevitably go that way and they will abuse things. They won't try to find the best combination of ways to play like us older guys do and a lot of you younger guys do to play the way that they want to play. Those kids that are like 9, 10, 11, and 12, they just want to find the easiest thing to do. And so that's why this year all you saw was sprint to the right, hesitate, cross back over, hesitate, and then kept doing that until you got open behind a screen and pulled. Like, that was the main thing that a lot of people saw. So now that they've got a new motion engine, we're hoping that all of that's gone. We know left-right ain't gone. We know Dex has been in the game for the last 10 years, so it's not gone. But we hope that there are some things that we can do to combat that. And it looks like that NBA 2K is on the right path with this, man. Check it out, man. Look, I'm just going to hit the major stuff, man. It just says, look, the motion engine. Proper footwork is the core foundation of basketball, and replicating that properly is vital to balancing the interplay between offense and defense. Yes. Because when you can run this way, cross and sweep back this way, run this way, hesitate, cross, sweep back, that's not basketball. You can't do that. That's not even a realistic depiction. When I can run this way, hard plant, and pirouette back this way, and run back, and hit somebody with that Dexter, yeah. When I can do that, that's not real basketball. A real foot plant, and if y'all want me to show y'all real movements and stuff like that, I'll show that to y'all in the gym today. You have to run, plant hard with both feet and then go back the other way. Or run, take a hard step, and then. But there's always some time that it's going to take before you can change directions. Anyway, I've been on my soapbox too long. Let's just go right into this, man. Look, proper footwork is at the core of basketball. Without realistic movement, everything else falls apart. We've been saying that for years. Left-right is not a realistic movement. This is not a realistic, this is a carry. But you can do that in the game. Jigging is not a realistic movement. So if you have to really plant your feet like you did in NBA Live 2008 and 2009, and if I can find that, I'm going to put that up on the screen. Like, bro, it'll be great. Let me see. NBA Live 09 foot planting. This is not anything that's new, but, we'll get to that in a second, man. Hopefully we can get to that. I'm just going to keep on rolling. Yeah, look, listen, they said we're going to have better foot planting last year, and you see what we got. But anyway, we don't care about all this stuff, man. Motion dribbling, handles, and sweet sauce, and sweet sides, and all of that good stuff, man. Listen, ball handlers now have contextual awareness of specific situations on the court that they didn't have before. Pick and roll, wraps, slips, situational cuts, backcourt and front court movement. We always had that because you couldn't hop step in the backcourt, but you could hop step in the front court when you get to a certain closeness to the rim and stuff like that. So stuff like that's been in the game. This is not anything that's new. Signature dribble styles were another key focus. The system, allowed them to upgrade and all that good stuff. We don't care about all of that, man. Let me see. We are adding concepts such as stop variations, dead leg hesitations, all that good stuff, man. Okay, so players like DeMar DeRozan who move with more wiggle, LeBron, Kawhi, and legends such as Kobe, Tim Hardaway, signature dribbles, and all that good stuff. So pretty much they say you're going to be able to differentiate between how you want to play, and if you put that player package on you, you might want that bull rush like Antetokounmpo and LeBron have, or you might want some finesse in your game like Kyrie and Jamal Crawford, or you may want no wasted motion like Steph Curry. So he just bam, bam, bam. So here's a list of the styles, man. We just gonna skim through this, and I'm gonna tell you how I feel about it. Bass is a style. Big is a style. There better be no crossovers in there, and they better assign that to every big, because if a big can get another package, why does it matter? Power, fundamental, quick, slasher. Slasher sounds nice, shifty. James Harden, a lot of people probably gonna use that. LeBron James, a lot of people probably gonna use that for the Bull West. Give him the Magic Johnson. Kobe out this mug. You got Jerry West, Dennis Johnson. Y'all don't even know who Dennis Johnson is. Y'all don't even know he has some of the best footwork and shiftiness in the game. Dennis Johnson was dope. Let me see, John Stockton. AI always been some of the weakest moves in the game on AI. Nobody used that crossover stuff. Man, grind hard. Tim Hardaway, the UTEP two-step. Steve Nash, former MVP, shouldn't have never got that. Kobe and Shaq should have got it those years. Jason Kidd, no wasted motion. Isaiah Thomas, the most underrated guard to ever. The most underrated Hall of Fame guard to ever play the game. Some of the best moves to ever do it. Chris Paul, some of the best to ever do it. D. Lillard, some of that shiftiness. Westbrook, a good mix of power and finesse. Kyrie, going to be a lot of shiftiness. Kemba Walker, no wasted motion. Steph Curry, no wasted motion. Paul George and Kawhi, bull rush with a little finesse to it, man. Like I said, being a successful ball handler is about rhythm, change of pace, and then, you know, you got the new system. It says the new system gives you those tools. What they're saying pretty much is you got new size of mechanics that you're going to be able to mix together with the left stick as well as the right stick. So the left stick, you're going to control pace and timing with the right stick. Left stick is going to be like pace and timing and how you want to move. And that's pretty much how it is now, how fast you want to move. If you want to move fast, you press the left stick all the way up. If you want to walk the ball up the court, you do it a little bit like that. But they saying this year you're going to be able to do it to another degree. And now you're going to have different size up. You'll be able to chain them together a lot better. And they also said that there are no prescripted movements. And they say that every year. You're going to have total control, complete freedom of movement. So I guess it's going to be like if you want, just like in 17, if you wanted to do the Kobe, instead of just tapping down or holding right trigger and tapping down on the right stick, where in 16 it would just do the Kobe backup for you, and in 17 you had to actually go between the legs. It's probably gonna be a lot like that, man, and you're gonna have to do that. It says no prescriptive sequences this year, so like that whole spin out that Stizo and them guys, Stizo gonna find a way to break the game. Get him in there, and then we'll find out if there's no prescriptive stuff in there or how hard it's gonna be. But like I said, if you want street ball moves, if you want fundamental moves, you're going to have Luka Doncic and his fake step back. You're going to have Kyrie with a whole bunch of street ball in his game. AI with a lot of street ball in his game. A lot of heads, a lot of crosses, and stuff like that, man. And all of that can be mastered. The only thing I'm really worried about is they can give us all the choices that we want to. We know that the 2K community doesn't care about choices. It's never any paralysis through analysis. We're just going to go to the YouTube, and we're going to wait for Brutal Sim, Shake, and Cizo to put out the best moves, and that's all everybody gonna use. So none of that even really matters. But somebody like me, I'll probably try to be unique and all of that good stuff. But you know, hey, we gonna see how it goes, man. But anyway, you know, it is what it is, man. Listen, hold on 1 second. We need another song, cause I don't wanna listen to nobody's cousin mixtape while we doing this. But anyway, so like I said, a successful ball handler is about rhythm and change of pace and all of that. What they're also saying is, this year, you're going to have, they're going to have all of this stuff. You're going to have all of these weapons at your disposal. But at the same time, they're going to have a new defensive system. And like I said, I obviously skipped over some stuff, but they got a new read and react defensive system. So it says that not only do they have new body ups, they have new systems, a new body up system. They got new stonewall. The stonewall was actually supposed to be when you tap circle or tap B when you beat somebody to the spot this year, and you can stonewall them, but it ended up being pushing, and then people abused pushing, and so they took it out of the game. So like, and they never really got that right. This year they're saying they got it right. It's gonna be better off-ball movements. I've always shown y'all the off-ball movements and how to defend people off the ball, how to push people out of the paint, keep them out of the paint, deny position and all that stuff. I've already showed y'all, but nobody cared then. Nobody ain't going to care now. They're just going to pick lockdowns and hope they play for them. Let me see. See, when defending, now they say that with the new read-react system, the better defender you are. Okay, so now they're going to have an arrow under the ball handler showing you where the ball handler is going to go. I surmise that by the time you realize where he's going, it's probably going to be too late, so it's not going to help you out all that much because the game can't tell where I'm going to go until I commit. And so while the game can instantly react, it takes a human being a quarter of a second to realize that they need to do something and then another quarter of a second to actually figure out what to do. And so seeing that arrow ain't going to help you out a whole lot if I keep changing. But anyway, they're saying the better defender you are, the more you're going to see that arrow. The faster you'll see that arrow in order to be able to play defense, cut people off. Hey, I would be fine with it if they would just bring back the 2K16 when the person was trying to drive, if you flick the stick to the spot at the last second, if you flick the stick, you could just straight stonewall them. If they brought that back, that would have been cool. But they, like I said, they're going to have an arrow under the ball handler telling you where they're going to go. And like I said, with the computer, that's broken because the computer can make that. The computer is reading your input anyway. So now they're just telling us, we've been reading your input the whole time. This is why you can't break the computer. So now, with that being the case, we're just going to pass that information on to you guys. I mean, so like I said, look. Hey, you can't. That's why you can't break the computer, because they're reading your controller data. So obviously we've already known that. Now they're gonna give us the ability to read the other person's controller data, pretty much. And as soon as it's just brain dead. Defense is gonna be brain dead. Turn your defense all the way up, and you'll know where the person is gonna go before they even know where they even able to go. It's just gonna put an arrow on the ground. But not only that, wait, there's more. They're gonna have a circle underneath the player. So when the circle is solid, then that's not a good time to reach. But when the circle is broken and shows up, that's a good time to reach. I couldn't imagine 2K, like, they really doing a great job of holding your hand this year on defense, as if they didn't do it enough this year. So now lockdown's gonna be stupid. Like, unless they can't shoot, then nobody's gonna play them, and everybody gonna swear they love playing lockdowns. And if they can't shoot, if they can't score this year, nobody's gonna play them. It is what it is, though. Like I said, we upgraded the system to make the game easier for you, because, and for casuals, because, believe it or not, hardcore players turn the lights on and keep you in your house. But casuals buy you the Ferrari. And so we're going to make this even easier for them. So even though offense might be a little bit tougher as far as dribbling and stuff, defense is going to be easy. You can literally play it as long as you got eyes, with your eyes open. So you'll be able to cut the person off. You'll be able to make them yield. You'll be able to make them pick up the ball. They say you're going to be able to make them pick up the ball this year. They said you'd be able to do it last year, but you couldn't. You weren't able to make them pick up the ball last year. Even Biggs was doing this right here, and then regathering, and then bam, bam, and then they was either pulling up or bam, bam, going to the hole, because you would be inevitably out of position. But hey, it is what it is. Like I said, if you're a highly skilled lockdown, you'll be able to see it faster. If you're not highly skilled, you won't be able to see it fast. I wonder if that's going to have something to do with badges as well, but we're going to get to that in a second. Check it out. All right, so shooting solutions and attacking the paint. They said that, looking at this, only thing it's really telling us is you'll be able to, like you know how you go in and you gather and then you try to go up, and he would either go up to the right or to the left unless you broke out of it with Acrobat. Now they're saying once you get ready to go up, you'll be able to kind of like fake this way and go back this way. You're going to be able to choose what you want to do. I don't know. It just seemed like a whole lot of cheese to me, man. It just says pretty much you can find a different shooting solution. If you're a slasher, obviously you're going to have a better chance of finding a different shooting solution and being able to do what you want to do. If you're not a slasher, hey, it is what it is, man. You're just going to be kind of out of luck if you're not a slasher. But hey, it says going in, you'll be able to go in. Let's say I started a Euro and then somebody steps in the way. Now I can do a Euro floater, or I can do a Euro dunk or whatever. They just got more ways to branch out of it now. But hey, with that comes the defense. And pretty much what they're saying is they're beefing up the defense too, because with everything, it's got to be counterplay, got to be counterpart. So you'll be able to capitalize off of hundreds of in-air collisions. I don't know if these are going to be unlocked by defensive stats, but or you're going to be able to choose, and we should be able to choose our defensive animations. They can choose their offensive animations. Why can't we choose our defensive animations? I think we should be able to. But they say, hey, welcome to the league, because somebody like Zion might be down there and might swat it with two hands or whatever. But, you know, listen, the more animations, the better. The more freedom that we get to choose the animations, the better. A lot of people are going to suffer from paralysis through analysis, so they're not going to really be able to choose nothing, and they're just going to choose what everybody else chooses or wait for other people to make videos. But that's good for me, because I'm one of those guys that show you how to do all the cheesy stuff and just be efficient. I'm not going to show you how to be flashy. I will show you how to be efficient. So make sure you hit the subscribe button and smack that like button. Anyway, working off ball in the Ask the 2K Dev segment. They teased the off-ball moves. Off-ball moves coming back. You can run them routes like in 2K, what was that, 14, 15? I know you can do it in 13 and 14. I don't know if you can do it in 15. But anyway, you can run routes. You can go back and forth. Working off the ball, it is real simple. You're going to be able to do stutter steps, chop your feet, inside outs, spins, fakes, all that good stuff, man. And then you can go somewhere and spot up for the J, or you can go on to the hoop. So you're going to be able to keep your defender on his toes. And that's a good thing, because as a shooter or a player that plays off ball a lot, I get tired of standing in the corner, man. Ain't nobody trying to stand in the corner all day long and just wait on other people. So if somebody sets a screen, I got more creative ways to get off that screen. And I like that, man. But, you know, and you got off-ball collisions, though, for the defense. Like I said, that must be balanced in everything. Perfectly balanced in every way. Look, if you're a defender, they got better off-ball collisions, better off-ball moves. I'm pretty sure you can step to the spot. If I know where you're going, I can step to the spot and keep you from going there, push you the other way, do all that stuff. You can always do that. I hope they bring back the ride animation from 2K 18 and 2K17, where I can just ride you out of the paint or do stuff like that. Like, or if you were running to the paint, I can keep riding you so you can do. I hope they bring that animation back, because that was a dope animation. I abused it to death because I knew how to use it. It was how to lock down the paint. But anyway, let me see. If you're off ball, off opponent tries to do something, you'll be able to step in and pretty much block them. Let me see. Screens, both on and on off ball, have been retuned. And so they're saying that you'll have, number one, they got this thing that's called a quick screen, where you'll be able to, you know, like Draymond screen, boom, and then go. High risk, high reward. They said you might get a lot of offensive fouls or a lot of illegal screens. We'll see about that. We know illegal screens are broken for the first year of the game anyway, and then they fix it. But anyway, like I said, you'll be able to set a screen. It's high risk, high reward, and but you got to use that sparingly. But other than that, they're saying that they're going to have a lot of ways to work yourself out of their screen, roll, fade, do different transitions. But on defense, we'll be able to reject the screen, and you'll be able to move around the screen a little bit better. And then they're going to have screen blowups where you can probably run through the screen. And then they're going to have, obviously, the hard-hitting brick wall screen. So, you know, it is what it is. I like the screen blowup idea, because a guard should not be trying to set a screen on a 7-3 center. It just shouldn't be happening. That shouldn't happen. He should run through that screen almost every time. And like, it's messed up, but you already can't really screen them, but, you know, it is what it is. Listen, but at the same time, they said they have different ways to move around the screen. I like that. One idea that me and T was talking about was that they should do, the longer you hold the screen in one position, the less effective that screen should become. That person should almost fade into an intangible object the longer that screen is there. Because in real life, the more I see this screen, the more I'm aware of it. Screens only really work when you're not aware of them. So if I'm aware of the screen and fully aware of it, and I have time to do something about it, the longer he stands there and holds that screen, the less effective it should be. But that's too much thinking for them, man. You know it is what it is. Now we're talking about, now we're going to talk about the next step is AI. We really don't care about that, because we don't let the AI play for us. You know, they're just saying, hey, Utah ball adjustments, Toronto's top lock deny scheme. Okay, yeah, that's cool. We don't play those games anyway. Badges and takeover. They said they got, that's real quick, they got about 80 badges in the game, and they want you to be able to express how you want to play. I don't know if that means you're going to be able to choose your badges, like, you know, choose like 5 badges and then go with that, or if you're going to have to, or if you can just work in whatever your archetype is, you can get the badges. Either way, I'm cool with that, as long as you have to work for it, because they're saying that you're going to be able to max the player out. Like, you know, when they were talking about, my man put out a tweet, Eddie2K was like, why stop at 85? You know, question mark. So maybe we're going to be able to go to 99 all the way in the prelude and see how the player can really play. Badges need to take a long time to grind, just like 17. You should have to be, if you want Hall of Fame Dimer, you should have to be in there working. A lot of people only had gold and silver dimer, if that, in 2K17. I hope badges take a long time to grind to be able to get those things. You have to have something to have some delineation between the people that paid to get where they are and the people that just that worked so they can be a little bit better. So badges, I hope they take a long time to grind. This year, badges didn't take a long time to grind, and the 99 took a long time to grind, and that's what made your player better. Now they're saying the 99 is not gonna take very long to grind. Just going by what LD said. So badges should take a long time to grind. But anyway, they said, so badges, 80 of them. They compliment your play style. I hope they don't give you the ability to do things. I hope they give you compliment, just allow you to be able to enhance your ability and not give you the ability like they did this year. Takeover, they said, more content, more features. They've balanced it out for all play styles, because we already know three shots with a shooter and he's in takeover, and now you got to commit two people to him. But it takes like five assists and a dunk and a layup and a three-pointer as a playmaker to do it. Some people said they get it off of one shot as a playmaker and they get it three times a game in the park. I'm not that good, and I never seen nobody do it. So, hey, it is what it is. But if you that nice, hey, you that dude, you should be in the 2K league, but I didn't see you play yesterday. So, hey, you must not be that nice. Anyway, it takes too long for playmakers to get it as opposed to other people to get it. Lockdowns is like two hard hits, and you can hit three shots in their face, and then they got it. So, it is what it is. I just wanted to be more balanced, but I also wanted to be like, if you're getting it, then you should be able to lose it also, because it's just all reward for that first one. If you ever try to get team takeover, you know what it is. If you make a mistake on the way to team takeover, you lose it all. I feel like it should be that way for the ordinary takeover. If I make a mistake in a game, a bad one, it should either go down to zero or it should go down significantly. So I also think the same thing with badges. I wish they would introduce dynamic badges. And what I mean by dynamic badges is, if you're shooting awful, your badge should deteriorate. It should decay. If you're getting cooked and you're a lockdown, your defensive Hall of Famer, obviously you're not a defensive Hall of Famer, it should be like a fine line, just like you're trying to level up. Or if you ever play League of Legends, like ELO, if you losing, then you should lose a few points toward the badge, and maybe it'll go down a tier. And if you really cooking, it should go on up, and hey, maybe it can max out at like a grand badge or something like that. Something still, or Hall of Fame should be the pinnacle. But maybe once you get Hall of Fame, you can decay depending on how you've been getting cooked, or if you're missing shots. If you're not shooting well, you shouldn't keep a Hall of Fame deep rain dead eye. Hey, it just is what it is. Badges should decay over time depending on your recent performances. I feel like that, but hey, that'll be too much. I'm too advanced for them. Anyway, like I said, takeover. Hey, takeover, like I said, they got tons more things, and more badges, more attributes. We're gonna get all that information as it comes. But we're looking forward to all that good stuff, man. In closing, hope you guys enjoyed the blog, and I expect to see you next month. Blah 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 blah, yakety smackety. This is a whole lot of nothing, man. It ain't no gameplay. Because that's what I want, gameplay. You can't finesse me, 2K. Give me all the information I want to. I don't see nobody moving. I see LeBron right here, but he's not moving. We want gameplay. I see Andre Drummond cocking it back. We don't care. I see who that is. That's Donovan Mitchell. I guess that's Donovan Mitchell right there. That's Serge. Serge right here doing this thing. And I forgot who that is, man. He was like sixth man of the year. But it is what it is, man. Look. Gameplay over everything. G-O-A-T. Gameplay over anything. And we're going to make anything be two words, even though it's one, and gameplay is one. So gameplay over anything. Yeah. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you leave a like, man. Tell me what you think about it. Is it just much to do about nothing, or you think it's going to be dope? I'm out of here. Till next time. It's your boy, J-Eazy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Holla! Make sure you like the video, subscribe for more daily 2K content. And I ain't even putting I'm not even gonna put a thumbnail over it, because this is gonna be the thumbnail right here. Peace. Ain't no gameplay, man! Bro, we already know what's gonna happen. Only thing people gonna do is find the cheesiest size up group, the cheesiest this, cheesiest that. It could be real good, it could be real bad. If they don't take Dixon out the game, like me and T-Mizzle said, you're gonna have people working off the ball and putting that together with Dexon. You're not going to be able to stop people off the ball. Hopefully, that's not the case. Hopefully, when you're using off-the-ball moves, it makes you use stamina, and that'll balance it out. It should almost drain your whole stamina to use one move, because you're not making 18 moves off the ball or whatever, but that's just me. That's my thoughts, man. I'm gone. Peace.